now to a local state investigation. SNL disconnecting the power with no notice or warning. Then comes the bill, and we're talking thousands of dollars just to get the lights back on.
Our Leave It to Larin investigation began with one customer, then there were two, and then we learned about dozens more.
This isn't our character. This is not me.
I haven't done anything wrong.
I'm like, what's going on? They couldn't explain to me what was happening.
They turned the power off.
And then say that I owe them $8,000.
They said, pay $12,000 or you don't get the power back on.
Jose Gaston lives in South Miami.
That's what they said.
Michelle Lopez lives in Plantation. In fact, Michelle's surveillance camera caught the Florida Power and Light crew that showed up one hot July day, disconnected her electricity, and then handed her a letter.
And it says that I tampered with their meter.
The meter was tampered with, and that I had done it.
Their letters read almost verbatim, detailing FPL's investigation into the alleged meter tampering. Both homeowners got adjusted statements dating back years, accounting for the higher wattage their meters should have been registering.
They're saying that they're smart meters, and it takes 6 years for the smart meter to figure out there's a problem. They're not so smart. And that's the new meter they installed.
That's the new one they installed after you paid the $6,000.
Correct. So that we could have power.
Now you're on a payment plan.
And now I'm on a payment plan. And now I'm talking to you to see if something can come out of this.
When Michelle's power was cut, she was in the middle of Hurricane Irma repairs. That work was forced to a halt when we met Michelle and her family.
Come, baby, come.
Fur baby included. They'd been living life with no lights for 2 weeks.
Never used this,
though. So this is how you're making your meals?
Yes.
A generator powered portable AC units at night during the day.
But this is our little routine. We close the door and relax and get some cool breeze. I need them to fix this and resolve it. That's what I need them to do. Why? I have lots of questions.
We contacted the State Public Service Commission, which regulates utility companies. If a utility, FPL included, even suspects meter tampering, the company can take action to not only investigate it, but stop it. Utilities are also allowed to cut service without notice if meters have been tampered with. We poured over dozens of complaints filed just within the past year from other South Florida FPL customers after getting their lights cut and hit with high bills after cases of alleged meter tampering. FPL says in 2018 it investigated and fixed 4,400 tampered meters, that about $4.5 million worth of energy had been stolen, which the company says only adds to its costs, affecting everyone's bills. An FPL spokesperson cited privacy reasons and could not comment on Jose and Michelle's cases, but in a statement says, the letters that we sent the customers are based on the facts we gathered after our thorough investigation. FPL stands by the meter tampering investigations that were conducted in both cases.
It's like right now I feel like I'm David and this is Goliath.
They have us. They have us and we got no choice.
Larry Livingston, Local 10 News.
The Public Service Commission helped the Gastons get in contact with FPL to set up his payment plan. Michelle Lopez filed a complaint, which customers can do with the PSC if they have an issue. But that's not all those homeowners can do. Larin has more tomorrow night at 11 right here on Local 10.